point in life if you understand me or not. Misunderstand me or not, me, I'm okay. I'm okay. And if you think I'm wrong or not, long as it's what I want, me, I'm okay. I'm okay. Cause who are you to judge me like say you be?
It don't worry. She touch for me at the end.
My name is Adeo Oni Emanuela. My name is Adeo Ojibotoro Ruda. My name is Amakus Fatima Adekuja.
My name is Adeo Wani Femi Catherine.
My name is Udoka Monique Kamsi.
My name is Rafaela Anna.
My name is Ayan Zaku Stephanie.
My name is George Brace Dari.
Jimmy Magalus.
My name is Ola Iwola Olajire.
Adegu Muslima.
I am Johnny Sariwa.
I am Adela Wani Femi.
Obijimi Michael.
I'm Alkayadi.
My name is Yena Chochamaka.
Allow me to inspire Abiola Sukoni.
My name is Ola Pisi Daniel.
Thank you very much.
How are you, Debbie?
Chef, would you feel full on?
Chips on me, Dad.
Will I be calling?
Very much.
Beautiful flavor.
My name is Lena.
Chukum Kiki Obu.
I like to just go.
Aisha Olumide.
My name is Olumide Waji Inok.
My name is
Alakunle
David.
My name is Oke Okekiwa Inok.
My name is Olariwaji Joshua Divine.
My name is Oshewa Damilari Samuel.
My name is Abikoye Emmanuel.
My name is Adedayo Kamsi Naomi.
My name is Adibanjo Kinsu.
My name is Thomas Ujo.
My name is Ryan Kintayo.
My name is Adeyi Damilari.
Chola Ajayi.
And my name is Ainde Fawaz.
My name is Ajayi Precious.
My name is Odumu Damilari.
My name is Olofunika Adrian.
Imanu Jordan.
Ibu Sumpu.
Mohamed Faisa.
Johnson Alundi.
Aoli Alami.
My name is Obinemi Shinayomi.
My name is Adebayo Akoredi Aliya.
Owani Oso.
My name is Obayiwana Edosa Uyefe.
Abubakar Abela.
Etoike Chidima Abitru.
My name is Ajiteru Samu.
Amasa Amerigo.
My name is Abini Uluwadosi.
My name is Ainola Oloa.
My name is Martin Mano.
No, Obafemi David.
George Olushola Beki.
My name is John Oluwani Fele.
Alabi Oluwa Shemilori, Jace Doria, Dokas.
Sulaiman Aluma Musroyo.
Kazim Oluwa Adamdola, Alusha.
Agro Fetia, I am Bosimbo.
That you should live in the moment and try to experience the most of everything.
I like to be proud of what and who I am.
I learned so much about friendships and how important it is to keep your true friends.
I've learned a lot. I learned to build my self-esteem because not everybody has to like you.
I've learned a lot. I've learned to be determined, resilient, and focused in all of my goals.
Well, I've learned a lot, and I've learned to stay determined and focused if I want to achieve anything good in life.
Loving myself is the best thing I can do. I'm like, not talking much does a lot of good.
I've learned that just have to be yourself, basically. That's all. I've learned that in order to achieve your goal, don't lose focus.
I've learned that you shouldn't allow your anger to take over you because it's going to take the better part of you.
Today, Ms. Ajibola punished me because she thought I gave someone my assignment copy.
The day I got called to principal's office for saying che, it does not even exist.
The day we went for basketball competition and made the school proud. I think my SS1 and SS2 days.
The day I fell in the middle of the field.
My first day as a student.
So every day we attend church.
We now go to the SS3. When we play over the class, and the fan cuts my hand.
I'm telling you not to let anybody lower your self-esteem.
Don't make too much friends. I know everybody's real.
But you should embrace change. Like, you should be able to adapt to situations.
Have sense and act mature.
Listen more. I'll tell him that he should believe in himself.
I feel that she grew up well, despite everything she grew up.
Tell him to be strong, not always rich.
My advice to juniors is that always be who you are.
But study harder.
Juniors, always be respectful to your teachers. And don't disrespect your parents too.
And my advice to juniors is always learn to make sacrifices. Learn to give up some things to achieve other things.
My advice to the juniors would be they should focus on their studies. They should stick to school. They should listen to their teachers most times, because sometimes they think the teachers are hard on them, but it's just for their own good. So they should focus, and there's always a time for everything. There's a time to play, and there's a time for your studies.
I'll advise them to work harder, because there's a lot of problems in front for them.
I'll advise them to study and work hard.
I'll advise them to step out of their comfort zones and challenge themselves.
I think that should be my friend, Idowu.
That would be my best friend, Kazim Damila.
I don't really know one of my friends.
Tari.
That would be Godwin Bernard.
Standing for worship.
Mola.
Mr. Ayo.
Amirogu, because his classes were fun.
Abafemi.
Standing for worship, because he gave me some advice I needed to reach where I am today.
Quite a few, actually. Mr. Babatunde, Mr. Ario, Mr. Anif, Mrs. Ajibola. Almost all the teachers that taught me.
Mr. Anif, Mrs. Ajibola, Mr. Adewale, and others.
A lot of teachers have impacted me in so many ways, but the one that still left his mark is Mr. Hazan. And that's my dearest teacher. He taught us so much. Not to always study, to always read, because during break times, a few weeks before exam, he always locked us inside the classroom. Even though most of us didn't want to stay, but he knew the benefits of it, and I really appreciated it.
I appreciate my SST teacher, Mr. Watsundi, my class teacher. He's apparently the best teacher I've ever had, like, in my experience, I would say. His style of teaching is actually entirely different from what I've ever experienced. He is also, like, very caring, and he listens to our problems, and he just, like, has the best solutions for everything.
I appreciate Mr. Atola because he helped me my self-esteem a lot. He's really a good teacher to me.
It's very hard to choose. I love especially my SS3 teachers. They've taught me a lot. They've taught me to be hardworking. They've taught me to build my self-esteem and just shine. They've taught me a lot.
To be sincere, all the teachers in ordinary schools have inspired me a lot to become who I am today.
All the teachers in ordinary schools have had, they are all good and they inspire me a lot. So, they all inspire me.
All my teachers actually, but especially Mr. Adewale. Basically all my teachers that taught me.
Mr. Ajibola, Mr. Sefuri.
The teacher is teaching and I want to excuse myself with the class. I will just ask for permission to go to the toilet.
Like, when I want to leave the classroom, I feel like I want to burn you. I want to leave the class. I just like, there's a time I know so that teacher wants to.
Sometimes I think that I want to use the toilet and then I'll calculate, I'll sell it for like 5 minutes, especially if the class is really boring.
If the teacher is a female, I'll tell the teacher that it's girl stuff, but if it's a male, I'll probably just lie that I'm pressed or something.
To use the toilet.
I want to visit at the nurse.
Like, I want to use the toilet. I'm pressed.
I'm feeling dizzy. Can I go to the toilet?
I'll just say, sir, I heard the bell.
Can I get something from the next class?
One thing I would love to do in Honeyland again is to relive my SS3 days, because my SS3 days have been the most successful, memorable, and impactful years of my life. So what's the point? Why not just do it again, better and brighter?
It would be to meet my friends again. I mean, they've been amazing to me all my life, and they're just amazing. Thank you.
My SS2 moments, because of my SS2 moments, were very interesting.
I would like to relive my Honeyland basketball days because I felt like when I played for competition, I did not have enough confidence, but now I'll play well.
I relive my SS2 days because they were interesting and fun.
The day that I became our principal.
Drama.
exciting.
Dynamic.
Complex.
Awesome.
Amazing.
If I were to describe Honeyland in one word, I would say exciting, yeah.
Drama.
Honeyland is wonderful. Amazing.
Fun.
The drama.
School life. The classroom. The classroom.
Okay, let's go.
The football pitch.
I always make sure that I read my book every night and stuff like that.
Always come to school on the first day to get the best seats.
I made friends with the head boy and the head girl, and I'm still friends with some of the prefects, and he's doing well for me.
Well, for me, I wake up in the night to read, and I don't know of other tricks, but you should study yourself.
Trick number one, avoid procrastination. Like my dad always says, last minute or come, don't do that. And try to read up every single thing you've learned in days or in weeks.
I set up a reading timetable to guide me and set reading hours for myself.
Set my goals, manage my time, and study effectively.
I try to stay organize my assignments, my reading timetable at home, so I can cope with school.
The day I first joined Honeyland.
The first day that I came to Honeyland school.
I think maybe year 10 days.
Year 10 days.
That would be the days, the moments I spent with my friends.
That was the day we finished work. We had fun.
Year 10 days.
My first time joining hostel.
The first time I got in trouble with the principal.
Moments in year 10, because they were awesome.
The day I was told to talk on assembly on because of prefect selection, and I didn't know what to say.
The day I was declared as the sport prefect, because it was a great honor to be a sport prefect of this college.
My set stages for now. Starting from me, I am a very, very determined person, and I see myself making big changes in the world 10 years from now. And as for the rest of my sets, I cannot speak for most of them, but I know that as for those that have their minds set to what they want to become, they should be able to do it with little or no sacrifices at all. Some people will lose their way, some people will not. My set is a very unique one. Many people have said it before. 10 years from now, I see them in good places.
Entrepreneurs.
Some of them, I see them in jail. Some of them may be politicians or doctors or lawyers.
I don't see us that far because right now we are not together that much. But I feel like everybody will end up doing what they plan to do.
Most of us probably own our own business and doing our own things.
I don't actually know, it depends.
I don't know, but I see everyone doing whatever they can to survive.
Honestly, I see all of us being successful.
I see myself being global.
To me, the person I'll miss the most is Robert Ido Esther, because she's been an impactful part of my life.
My best friend, Adebiyo Luanfin.
My best friend, Isamari Franco.
I don't feel like there will be space to miss anybody, because I feel like all of us will still go to Babcock, because that's where everybody's going right now.
Steve Cannon Precious a lot.
Adora, I have the first seat.
Azim Damlola.
Z, Y, X, V, U,
Z, Y, X, W, U, V, K,
Z, Y, X, W, B, U, T, S, R,
Algeria, America, Atlanta.
America, Atlanta,
America, Algeria.
The world of creation, direct and only cause, guide our leaders right, ever use
the... Oh God of creation, direct our noble cause, something.
Oh God of creation, direct our noble cause.
Oh God of creation, direct our noble cause, guide our leaders right, help our youth the truth to know, in love and honesty to grow, and live in just and truth. They love to hurt and tear, to build a nation where peace and justice shall reign.
First, I'll see if
Finland, France, Denmark,
Denmark, Dutch land.
Love school because it brings success, which gives me money.
Ali go to school, but Ali go more. Ali leave the school, but Ali born only. Success. And Tsunami was a successful boy. Then he left home. Tsunami. Be like tsunami. Money. Money must be made to make your future bright. Yes, money must be made. Yes.
Honeyland, the school of peace, a citadel built of God, where they groom the future. Success is mine in the name of the Lord. Success is mine. All we want is money. No one cares about each other anymore.
She works in a shoe shine shop. Where she shines, she sits. And where she sits, she shines. Susie works in a shoe shine
shop.
Sushi works in a shoe shine shop when she's shining.
Well, it has been an amazing experience with this set of students, this set of achievers, the class of 2023 graduating set. Your time here in secondary school has been wonderful, exhilarating, challenging. There are moments you never liked us. There are moments you picked offense in our decisions, especially my decision. But that journey has come to an end today. Either way, it has been a fulfilling journey. It has been so much fun. It has been so much of a thing. You always look back and say, thank God I attended Honeyland. Honeyland, as you know, is a school that always like to bring the best out of every student, and your set is no doubt is not an exception. So I just want to leave you with this word, that all that you have learned here, don't discard them. Don't do away with them. Don't see them as if they are a waste of time. Yes, at those periods of time that we were putting you through, we are not really in tune with us, but there are things that will help you in the future. There are tools that you need to use to excel. I wish you all the best as you start another phase of your life. Some of you are going to attend university here in Nigeria and some outside the country. Either way, learning is the same process. Take all that you have learned with you, go with them, and they will help you. Don't forget that life itself is a challenge. Everything that you need to overcome this challenge or challenges, God will definitely give you. I pray as you graduate today that heaven will go with you. No form of evil will come near you. Your parents will not cry over any of you. Whatever you lay your hands on by God's grace shall prosper. I wish you all the best. Most importantly, where we took you to the correctional home, it's not just for you to go there and have fun. It's just for you to know what are those things that I need to learn, what are those things that I need to avoid in order not to run into trouble. So please take this and make use of them. I wish you all the best. Never forget your alma mater. Never disappoint your parents. And ultimately, don't disappoint yourself. I wish you all the best.